A320 Mentor Channel. Thanks for watching.
What do the green tick marks on each side of the PFD display represent?
The green tick marks are at 67 degrees. That is the maximum angle of bank I can command in normal law. I cannot command any greater than 67 degrees.
Is there anything in normal law that would limit you to 45 degrees of bank?
If I were in high speed or low speed protection, I would be limited to 45 degrees of bank.
Assume that you are in high speed protection. You command 45 degrees of bank and then let go of the side stick. What will occur?
The aircraft will roll back to zero wings level. The reason for that is that it is trying to protect itself from over-G'ing or a graveyard spiral.
What about low speed protection when you've commanded the same 45 degrees of bank and then let go of the stick?
In low speed protection, it will just roll back to 33 degrees because in this case, it is not concerned about over-G'ing.
With that in mind, any bank angle that's greater than 33 degrees and you let go of the side stick, what occurs?
It will roll back at least to 33 degrees.
What about a bank angle between 0 and 33 degrees?
Between 0 and 33 degrees and not in high speed protection, the aircraft will maintain whatever bank angle it is at.
Is there anything that may occur beyond 33 degrees bank?
Beyond 33 degrees of bank, I am going to lose auto pitch trim. Once I get to 45 degrees, I will lose the autopilot and flight directors.
In normal law, describe to me the pitch limitations, pitch up and pitch down.
With the aircraft in normal law, the maximum pitch up that we can attain is 30 degrees. As we get to 30 degrees, energy will deplete and then it will be limited to 25 degrees. That is true for all flap configurations except for flaps full. With flaps in full configuration, we are limited to 25, and as energy depletes, it will decrease to 20 degrees. Nose down, regardless of the configuration, the maximum is 15 degrees.
What indications will you see that you have these protections?
You'll see green tick marks at 30 degrees pitch up and at 15 degrees pitch down, just like these green tick marks.
Explain G protection in normal law.
Load protection in normal law is from 2.5 positive G's to minus 1 G when we are in clean configuration or slats only. If we have trailing edge flaps out, the range is limited from positive 2 to 0 G's. That protection is available in normal law and in alternate law. However, once in alternate law, the limits still apply, but they are no longer protections.
How would you degrade from normal law?
Well, there are two different ways you can degrade. One is the catchphrase, multiple failures of redundant systems. The other way is getting into an abnormal attitude.
What would be some specific indications that you are in degraded flight control law or even alternate law?
The easiest way to determine that you're out of normal law is by looking for amber X's that will have replaced the normal law green tick marks at 67 degrees on the PFD. Also, you would no longer have the Alpha Prot and Alpha Max Tiger's Tail. Instead, you would have VSW, the red and black bumblebee. You would also lose the green tick mark on the speed tape, as well as the green pitch limit ticks, if you could see them.
What would tell you specifically that you were in alternate law?
Well, the ECAM will display the message, alternate law protections lost.
Is there any mode that you may not or don't have available in alternate law?
You will not have pitch or bank angle protections.
Alternate law is called alternate with speed stability and alternate without speed stability. How can you tell if you have or don't have speed stability?
You will not be able to tell from your aircraft, except if you have stability. With it, if you get slow, the nose will pitch down slightly to keep from getting too slow, and if you get fast, the nose will pitch up to keep you from overspeeding.
Can you override that protection?
Absolutely.
You are on approach in alternate law. You put the gear down. What will occur?
When you put the gear down with the autopilot off, the aircraft goes into direct law.
Is there some visual indications which indicate that you are in direct law?
Well, the easiest way is to read the amber PFD message indicating use man pitch trim. Or you can look down at ECAM and it will read direct law protections lost.
Are there any protections available under direct law?
No, there are no protections. You have VSW, but that is only an oral warning, not a protection.
If you get the red man pitch trim only, what law are you in?
You are in mechanical backup.
What items are available in mechanical law?
Well, not really too much. You will have manual pitch trim just as the annunciator indicates. Then you have two other controls. The rudders are available, connected directly by cables to hydraulic actuators, which allow rudder movement. You also have thrust capabilities. Asymmetric thrust really doesn't do much for you, but combined thrust really does play a major factor in pitch. Add thrust to the low-slung engines on the 320 gives you a pitch up. Reduce thrust, and you get pitch down.
Finally, there's one other law called abnormal attitude law. With all the protections available in normal law, how would you ever get into abnormal attitude law?
The law really tells you. You can't get there by yourself. It's abnormal, and you have to be put there by an outside source such as wingtip vortices, wind shear, or some other outside force causing the airplane to abnormally roll or pitch.
What kind of parameters would the aircraft have to exceed to be forced into abnormal attitude law?
Well, the easy way to remember is just double the maximum parameters of bank and pitch we have already discussed. For example, pitch up limits are 30, 25, and 20. 25 is the mean. Double that and you have 50. For pitch down, it is 15. Double is 30. Maximum roll is 67. Double that is approximately 125. Finally, there are some speeds which apply, but usually your friendly examiners don't ask about them, but just in case. They are exceeding 440 knots or 0.91 Mach, or if you go slower than 60 knots or 0.1 Mach.
You have entered, or how about been thrown into, abnormal attitude law and have recovered. Do you revert back to normal law?
No, you definitely do not go back to normal law. You go into something similar to alternate law. You will have stability and yaw dampening. The big difference is that you get flare mode back.
A320, Mentor Channel.